You're wearing your mask, you're doing your part, and how does your skin repay you? With Maskne, Alexa Lee found out how to prevent and treat this new form of acne.
While you are wearing a mask to protect others, you may have noticed some skin issues as a result. Well, Dr. Cynthia Henry from the Westlake Office of Apex Dermatology is here with help, and we are very grateful. Welcome to the show.
Hi, thank you. Thanks for having me.
So people are actually, I mean, we've already come up with a terminology for this, maskne. Oh, goodness.
Yes. So maskne is a phenomenon that has happened in the past, but now it's much more prevalent because we are wearing masks, which we should be. It's where acne is exacerbated by putting on a mask and having mechanical or external rubbing of the skin on acne-prone skin. So we've seen this in the past with people who work in operating rooms, who wear masks for long periods of time. We also see it in patients such as football players who wear helmets and have dirt and oil on the skin with rubbing of helmets in different parts of the head and neck. So it's something now, though, for the larger population, we are seeing it and it's more prevalent.
Right. And obviously, some of us are wearing masks all hours of the day. And, you know, and then we were talking before the show about teenagers who are already having skin issues. So this has been around. Now it's more prevalent. How are you treating it?
You know, we're treating it very similarly to treating all acne patients. We're looking at each individual, what their goals are for their treatment of acne, as well as what their specific problems may be, whether it be sensitive skin, what treatments they've used in the past, and getting them a very good skin regimen, a skincare regimen, starting from washing all the way to using either prescription or over-the-counter preparations to help with those breakouts.
And I understand, like you mentioned, that, you know, we're all individuals. I come in from wearing the mask for 30 minutes and I have, you know, irritation. I have red marks already. So I know that you have different treatment plans for everybody. Can you kind of describe what those plans might be?
Sure. In general, we're using, thinking about using gentle cleansers and having a face that is clean before applying the mask. In addition to that, there can be topicals that can be used, such as salicylic acid and benzoyl peroxide for those breakouts. Another thing that we think about with mask wearing is after the mask is being able to be taken off is to wash the skin with that gentle cleanser again and moisturize to increase the skin barrier and to help with any irritation that may occur with the mask use also.
Okay, so I'm sure for everyone, it's good just to moisturize and keep it from getting, because sometimes I notice just the dry lines from the mask rubbing. Do you have any other tips that we can do to kind of just prevent and keep our skin healthy?
Yeah, so it's important that the mask be fit properly. Mm-hmm. So you may have to look around and find masks that are made of cotton and of silk. Those with the internal layer being those two materials can lead to less irritation and better breathability next to the skin. You also want to think about having a mask that's properly set on the face so that it doesn't have to be moved around a lot. With any movement of the mask on the face, that leads to more irritation and possible acne. So you want to have a mask that you can set in place and it stays so that it's, you know, properly tied around the ears or around the head. And so you're not constantly moving it around. That can also help.
Dr. Henry, thank you so much. These are great tips. And clearly this is going to be an ongoing situation that we're going to have to deal with. So we want to be able to do it right. And I believe you just opened an 8th location in Ashtabula. Is that correct?
That is correct. Yeah, we're open for business there to help our acne patients as well as any general dermatology patients.
Oh, well, wonderful. Congratulations. And I know that you are, of course, practicing safety and having the precautions set in place that are needed to be. So that's good for everybody to know. And the phone number that everyone at home can call is 833-279-SKIN. So that's 833-279-7546. You can also go to apexskin.com for more information. Dr. Henry, thank you so much. We appreciate you.
Thank you so much for having me.
This segment of It's About You was sponsored by Apex Dermatology. Save.